In fact, breaking news coming in on headlines today. We've learned from reliable sources that the Supreme Court's recommendation of making Sunil Gavaskar the BCCI chief will not be acceptable to the petitioners against the BCCI, in this case the Cricket Association of Bihar. We learned that their counsel are planning to request the Apex Court to suggest another name in play to replace BCCI chief Srinivasan. The petitioners will be requesting the Supreme Court to suggest an alternate name, and ever since Gavaskar's name in fact has come up by the Supreme Court, questions have been raised over his credibility. Remember, he owns a player management company, PMG it is called. He also is on the payrolls of the BCCI and also is contracted with an Indian news channel. What we also learn is that the BCCI on its part is likely to represent Anil Kumble as the name that should replace N. Srinivasan in the interim. Joining me on the show, Deputy Editor of India Today, Kunal Indian player Nikhil Chopra. Let me go across to Kunal first up. Kunal, no surprises that Sunil Gavaskar's name is going to be challenged in the court tomorrow. But what about Anil Kumble? Is it better or worse off?
See Shivani, unfortunately, you know, a number of our players have not really covered themselves in glory when they've had a chance to govern. You know, when Anil Kumble became president of the Karnataka State Cricket Association, everybody saw it as the right move. I mean, this is what we want, that, you know, cricket should come under cricketers. But, you know, what happened after that was very questionable. A few days later, you saw Kumble sitting on the table of an IPL franchise, advising them. You know, I don't see why the Karnataka State Cricket Association president should be doing that. And then, you know, there was this whole controversy about his company, Tenwick, which was, you know, giving, he was mentoring players who he controlled in a way as the president of the Karnataka Association, how, you know, equipment was been given to NCA. And, you know, Kumble has since moved out of Karnataka State Cricket Association.
But you know, he's still with Mumbai Indians.
And it again raises questions about, you know, this insider sort of business that goes on in the BCCI all the time. And, you know, I really think, and, you know, I think a lot of people feel that the BCCI right now needs to be controlled by somebody from the outside, because they have shown time and again that they're incapable of handling their own affairs. And it's not an aspersion on, you know, the quality of these players or on their administrative skills or the intention that they have. But it's just that the system has been so closed for too long that we need an outsider to come and open it.
Absolutely. Let me also go across to our consulting editor, Boria Majumdar, who's joining us. Boria, we learned that Sunil Gavaskar's name is going to be opposed, but Anil Kumble's name is bound to raise the question of conflict once again.
Absolutely. You know, I could hear my colleague Kunal Pradhan talk about the Mumbai Indians point. You also made the same point. Also, there's Tenwick. You know, he runs this player management company called Tenwick. Now that manages players like Vinay Kumar, that manages players like Abhimanyu Mithun. Now how can you have a player management company which runs Indian players and you yourself be the president of the board of control for cricket in India? That is just too bad, I mean, in terms of the conflict of interest issue. Again, it is not an aspersion on Kumble per se, but it is about the system and what will give our faith back. I don't think Anil Kumble or even Sunil Gavaskar, who is on record today that he will not relinquish his television contract with a particular television channel, he will not give up his BCCI commentary contract. He too runs a player management agency, professional management group, which has Cheteshwar Pujara, Manoj Tiwari in its ranks. I don't think any of these names will cut the ice, because both have serious issues of conflict of interest.
All right, let's recap for our viewers. Breaking news that we're getting right now is that Sunil Gavaskar's name is going to be opposed by the petitioners in this case as a suggestion for the interim president's post. On the other hand, the BCCI is likely to recommend Anil Kumble. But as we were just talking about, Anil Kumble too has questions of conflict of interest. So it's very likely that the petitioners will challenge his candidature also. But let's just recap, before we go any further, let's recap the day for our viewers. The BCCI once again issuing almost an ultimatum to the body, the Supreme Court issuing an ultimatum to BCCI saying Srinivasan has to go. Again, it's given them a day to respond. Tomorrow morning, though, we are expecting that the Supreme Court will pass at least three important interim orders. Take a look.
Sir, will you be stepping down today?
On Tuesday, the Supreme Court said if Srinivasan did not step down, it would be forced to act. And it did on Thursday, making its mind very clear in uncertain terms, even though the bench called them proposals. The first was that Sunil Gavaskar should replace Srinivasan as the interim president of BCCI. Rajasthan Royals and Chennai Super Kings should be barred from IPL 7. And employees of Srinivasan-owned India Cements should stay out of BCCI. The BCCI has only 24 hours to file its response to the proposals.
सर्वप्रथम श्रीनिवासन को बीसीसीआई के अध्यक्ष पद से रिमूव किया गया है और उनके जगह में जब तक ये मुकदमा चलेगा भारतीय क्रिकेट के महान क्रिकेट खिलाड़ी सुनील गावस्कर बीसीसीआई के अध्यक्ष का कार्यभार संभालेंगे और 16 अप्रैल से जो आईपीएल होने वाला है उसमें चेन्नई सुपर किंग और राजस्थान रॉयल की टीम पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करेगी.
But there was more drama in court. The petitioner's counsel Harish Salve put the Indian cricket captain in the dock. Salve accused Dhoni of lying in front of the Mudgal committee. Salve said Dhoni was involved in corrupt conduct. Salve questioned Dhoni's conflict of interest.
I have not seen the proposal. I have not seen what it is all about. And these matters are in the court. So, you know, we have to wait for these court judgments. I don't want to get into commenting on a court judgment and a matters are sub judice. So better not to get into matters.
Matter is already sub judice as you are aware. So let's wait for the final verdict of the court. Court has given some suggestions and there'll be arguments tomorrow. And after that, a final verdict would come. So let's wait for that.
And whatever the verdict is, the final verdict is of the Supreme Court, I'm sure all of us as law-abiding citizens will abide by the decision of the Supreme Court.
In the perception of the court, in the perception of the people, there is a loss of confidence in the board, and the members, I think, should now rise above individuals and look at the larger interests of the board.
But there could be a new twist in this saga. Questions are being raised whether Gavaskar is the right man for the job.
क्योंकि तीन चीज़ें हैं गावस्कर साहब के खिलाफ. एक तो शुरू से ही आईपीएल के वो गवर्निंग काउंसिल के मेंबर रह चुके हैं. मिलियन डॉलर कॉन्ट्रैक्चुअल डील्स हैं उनकी. वो एक बीसीसीआई के पेड एम्प्लॉय हैं और आपने देखा पिछले 5-6 साल में वो बीसीसीआई के खिलाफ बिल्कुल कुछ बोलते ही नहीं हैं.
व्हाटएवर द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू मे बी, द एपेक्स कोर्ट विल बी अनाउंसिंग इट्स डिसीजन ऑन फ्राइडे एंड दैट कुड बी द फाइनल नेल ऑन कॉफिन फॉर श्रीनिवासन. Sports Bureau headlines today.
Right, the news that we're breaking right now at Sports Quarter, that Sunil Gavaskar's name indeed will be opposed by the petitioners. Anil Kumble's name will be floated by the BCCI side. Let's also listen into Aditya Verma and what he had to say. He's the petitioner in the case and what he had to say on Sunil Gavaskar's name being floated. Listen in.
इवन सुनील गावस्कर साहब के नाम पे हमारे कोई एक और काउंसिल कुछ कोर्ट को आपत्ति भी जताए हैं कि, लेकिन कोर्ट ने सारे चीज़ों को किनार करते हुए अंतरिम अध्यक्ष के व्यवस्था के रूप में सुनील गावस्कर साहब को सामने कोर्ट ने ला दिया है.
All right, Kunal Pradhan, Nikhil Chopra, Borya Majumdar, and also my colleague Sameep Rajguru is now joining us from Dhaka. I want to go to Sameep first. Sameep, today is a day when Indian captain Mahendra Singh Dhoni's name has been taken in court and not in a very favorable light. The Indian team practiced in Dhaka before their match against Bangladesh tomorrow, and Rohit Sharma came from for the press conference and not the captain. I believe questions were raised, but there were no answers coming from the Indian player.
Yes, absolutely, Shivani. And I was listening to Kunal and Borya also about Sunil Gavaskar's name will be opposed. But whatever it is, I spoke to a few people here in Bangladesh, a few commentators and everybody. I would like to share their opinion on Sunil Gavaskar's name. They said whatever it is, he might be running a few companies or one company or whatever. He is in the IPL governing body, but he is one of the biggest player India has ever produced. And he probably has the best reputation. So Gavaskar's name is the right name if court has proposed. So whatever it is. Now, whatever has happened in Delhi, everyone is looking at Dhaka now. Whether it is you or the cricketers or the fan, everyone wants to know what is happening in Dhaka. Dhoni skipped the press conference, which proves the point that Dhoni knows what has happened back home. Because Dhoni knows what will happen in press conference. Rohit was sent instead. And Rohit, of course, avoided, ducked all the questions. And he said, I don't know what is happening. We are resting in our room. And we are here to practice and we'll do our nets. And one of the journalists from he's our own Mail Today journalist Mr. Kasser asked him, are you following the news on television? He said, no, we are not following. But I'm pretty sure everyone knows what is happening, because when I saw them in the nets, they were a little over the board aggressive. There was a swagger in their appearance and in their body language, which usually you won't see cricketers in that kind of a mood or something like that, whatever right. It is. And Dhoni played a lot of football. And he was giggling and laughing. His body language was, I felt, was a bit overconfident, and he wanted to show that he's not nervous or he's not, bothered right. About what has happened back home.
Yes, it's quite natural. Sometimes you overcompensate for what is happening, and maybe that was what was happening with the Indian captain as well. But Boria, the next question is just what happens from here on now? The proposals that the Supreme Court has laid down, do you expect the BCCI to come up with a response that again challenges these proposals? They will try to fight it out tomorrow in the court?
They will. It's upon CA Sundaram to come up with a plan that the Supreme Court might accept. Herculean task for CA Sundaram, no chance. But the fact is, the BCCI will say 24 hours is not enough time to convene a special general meeting. So how can they come up with tangible responses to these proposals? It involves the future of Indian cricket. They need a bit more time. So give them about 72 hours. Push the hearing back to next week. They will say a lot of things. They will certainly oppose Sunil Gavaskar's name. Sameep Rajguru was saying about commentators. But maybe some of those commentators he are referring to has not spoken to Mr. Srinivasan or his gang yet. So the BCCI will certainly oppose certain things. They will surely oppose the fact that two teams will be suspended from IPL season 7, because then the tournament goes for a toss. Whether or not the Supreme Court buys it, chances are they won't, because they have gone too far ahead with this, and they know that the BCCI is a cozy club that my colleague Kunal Pradhan was repeatedly mentioning in the afternoon. So this is a fact. Whether or not the Supreme Court will buy it, we don't know. Chances are it won't. Chances are you will get the three interim orders that you mentioned at the start of the show.
Yes, Kunal, the question that we have been discussing too, what should happen? What view should we take? Because if you allow someone else to take in from the board, nobody really has a lot of faith in the fact that it will actually lead to a cleanup of the body and its functioning. Would you like a CBI inquiry while, let's say, somebody takes interim charge? Or would you like a body committed by the Supreme Court, constituted by the Supreme Court to take over the BCCI's functioning?
No, I would definitely like a body constituted by the Supreme Court to take over. I mean, whether they decide that or not is there, and a CBI probe, and a regulator put in place to handle Indian cricket. Like, all billion-dollar business must be regulated. See, Shivani, the important point is that, Indian cricket has got various opportunities over the last 15 years to clean up its act. It has never done it. Mm-hmm. It has every time, as I was saying in the morning, cut off, the hand that is soiled and, grown a different hand and moved on. This, we should look at this as another window of opportunity. It's a golden opportunity. If we lose it now, we're never going to have a chance again. Because, after this, what else is left?
Yeah.
Your board president is in the dock. He has been told to leave. Words such as nauseating and filthy have been used to describe the BCCI and his role in it. The Indian captain's name has today come up. The conflicts of interest in the BCCI run so deep that if you start listing them, you're going to fill a whole newspaper page. At a time like this, you need an outsider to come, because these people are incapable of cleaning up their act.
Nikhil, the other question is that, the BCCI's reputation, as Kunal is saying, is being sullied every day. The fact that no official response has come from them. Even today, Mr. Ravi Sawant spoke to us, says, well, we don't have enough time. Well, they do a video conference, show some will, show some proactiveness to suggest that, okay, we care about what the Supreme Court is doing. Everybody's just playing their wait and watch game.
Well, without a doubt, I can tell you wherever they are, they all care. And they all must be trying to figure out what we can do. And hopefully, after tomorrow, somebody or the other has got to hold a press conference to say how things are going to go ahead. And like Kunal says, this is the best opportunity, Shivani, to just clean up the entire act. I'm not saying that BCCI has done a really bad job over the years. They've done some fantastic jobs as well. But this is an opportunity. Don't forget, the picture that we're talking about here is look at how the irregularities have happened in the IPL, the spot fixing, the match fixing. That is the probe that we're talking about. And you must have an independent agency to go out there and try and look at what's happened, clean it up, whether it's talking about suspending these two teams and the tournament goes ahead with the six teams. Fair enough, these two teams get suspended. Otherwise, for 1 year, even if the tournament gets suspended, it's not such a bad idea. Because come the next year forward, If you play, if you come up with an absolutely clean IPL, the BCCI regaining their trust, I think it'll be fantastic. And, you know, for whatever they've done over the past, this is an opportunity that whatever's gone wrong in the recent past, this is an opportunity to clean it up.
The Supreme Court's observations against the BCCI. The next question to ask really is, can the IPL really survive the kind of questions now that are being asked by the Supreme Court of the company, of the country, and the kind of observations that could come tomorrow? Borya, what is your thought before I take Kunal and Nikhil's view as well? Do you think the IPL can survive the suspension of two teams?
It can survive provided it wants a cleanup. It cannot go on with this fashion this year for sure. If it wants to come back in a new avatar in 2015, so be it. If it's a brand which has some real solidity and robustness, maybe the BCCI should think of bringing it back in 2015. But if it tries to be brazen and push a tournament down the fans' throat this year, it won't survive. Quickly, I also want to make this point that whether it's a CBI inquiry or whatever it is, the man who has been at the center of this, Justice Mukul Mudgal, should be empowered to oversee that inquiry. Only then can you, you know, ensure justice. Because all of this has happened thanks to that man's report, right, which could not be influenced in any shape or form by the BCCI.
Right. Kunal, your view on the IPL as a brand and whether it can actually continue like this?
Shivani, you know, very frankly, I am not interested in the survival of the IPL or the fall of the IPL. I think we should all be concerned at this moment about what's happening in Indian cricket, and the IPL is only a symptom of that. See, for too long, the IPL has been sold like, you know, this great thing that's happening, which is showcasing the highest quality of cricket with all the top people involved, you know, while actually it is actually the lowest and the easiest form of cricket that is played in the world right
but
now.
But it gives young players
chances. It does. It has its merits. But at the same time, you know, your great test players are not going to come from the IPL. They're going to come from your Ranji Trophy cricket, your domestic cricket, which we have completely ignored at the altar of the IPL. Meanwhile, everything that is going on in the IPL, we know. You know, there has been, you know, at one point I said the IPL should be renamed IPC because, you know, it is hell bent upon breaking every rule of the IPC over the last 5 years, over 5-7 years.
So, and you know, there's been a major controversy every year.
There are 6 controversies every year, and actually the IPL relishes it. You know, it really enjoys the controversies it gets into, which is all good, all very well. But, you know, I think the point of interest right now is to be Indian cricket on the whole.
Yeah.
And if the IPL has to be sacrificed temporarily for that, cleaned up completely, like Borya was just saying, you know, so be it. And, you know, when it comes back, it should please come back with the right sort of perspective. You know, it's a domestic tournament of 2020 cricket, you know, where people have to be fit to bowl 4 overs and play 40 balls.
Yeah.
And, you know, let us not treat it as the be all and end all of all cricket existence.
And with the right people at the helm
absolutely.
As well. Nikhil, very, very quickly, I have like 10 seconds left.
A slight difference opinion. If the two teams get suspended, so be it. I guess nobody's going to be questioning the Apex Court.
No, but there are larger questions on the league.
Yeah,
Sundar Raman's name has been
but
taken.
But to me, I hope the tournament continues, even if it's the six teams like you were talking about. It gives a youngster an opportunity to go out there and showcase his talent. So, you know, and because of three people's mistakes, the other six franchises shouldn't bear the brunt.
All right, on that note, we'll have to end our special presentation here. Kunal Pradhan, Borya Majumdar, Nikhil Chopra, and also my colleague Sameep Rajguru, who joined us from Dhaka. Thanks a lot. We'll keep bringing you all the latest developments in this story. Keep watching Headlines today. Goodbye.